I'm gonna show you a super slick way to tackle some line problems. And here's the best part. You already know how to do this. You might just not realize it yet. Now here's the problem. We're gonna try to find an equation whose graph is a line through 2, 1 and has slope negative 3. Now there are other ways to do this problem. I'm gonna let that other guy show you those because our way is better. Now here we go. We're gonna start off just by graphing the line first. 2, 1, that point is right there. Now a slope of negative 3, rise over run is negative 3. Slope is negative, that means, well, a rise, we're going to go down 3 when we go right 1. So down 3, right 1. Down 3, right 1. Or we could reverse that. If we're going to go up 3, we have to go left 1. Again, because the slope is negative. Up 3, left 1. Now we can connect these dots. And we got ourselves a line. But we don't have an equation. Well, we know this point right here. This is 2, 1. We know the line goes through this point. Now imagine we have any other point on the line. We're going to call that x, y. And this point, x, y, has to be on the line. Right? Take any other point. What do we know about this point? Because it's on the line. We know that its slope between that point, x, y, and the point that we were given, 2, 1, has to be negative 3. That's what it means to live on this line. Any two points on this line, the slope between them has to be negative 3. There's one that we're given, and there's another one right there, x, y. So the slope between x, y, and 2, 1 has to be negative 3. And we know how to find the slope between these two points. You take the difference in the y-coordinates, and you divide by the difference in the x-coordinates. And that gives you the slope, and we know that has to be equal to negative 3. And there we go. We've got an equation. Now, we can't just leave it like this, because what happens if we put 2 and 1 in there? Boom, you're dividing by 0. No dividing by 0. But now, if we multiply both sides here by x minus 2, now look what we're sitting on. Y minus 1 equals negative 3 times x minus 2. There we go. That's a nice linear equation right there. Now we can clean this up a little bit. I'm going to multiply out the right-hand side. Minus 3 times x minus 3 times minus 2 gives us 6. Clean this up a little bit more. I like all my variables on the same side. I'm going to bring the 3x over here. Added 3x to both sides. I'm also going to add 1 to both sides. Get all my constants over there. That's a nice, clean, simple equation. We can check this out as well. Take the point that we were given. Does it work in here? 3 times 2 is 6. Add the 1. We get 7. Let's test another point. Line looks like it goes through right here is 3, negative 2. Let's try that out. We put x equals 3 in here. We get 3 times 3 is 9. Add the negative 2. We get 7. Looks like we have a winner. Now, there's nothing particularly special about this point, 2, 1, and this slope, negative 3. This should work with any point, any slope. Let's check that out. Here we go. Any point, any slope. Imagine we just kind of visualize a picture of that. There's our any point on any old line. Now, just like we did before, we say that xy is some other point on this line. Now, if xy is living on this line, that means the slope between xy and x1, y1 has to be m. That's what it means to live on this line. So once again, we break out our definition of slope. Difference in the y-coordinates divided by the difference in the x-coordinates. And we know that the slope of this line has to equal m. This is what I meant. This is nothing new. You already know this. We're just using the slope to figure out what the equation is. Again, we multiply both sides by that denominator. We just clean this up a little bit. And there's our equation. We're finished. Just like that, we've got an equation whose graph is this line. And all we did was use something we already knew, the slope. So we don't even have to memorize this as something different and something new to learn. There is a name for it because you know how we mathematicians are. We like to name everything. We've got a really clever name for this. It's called the point-slope form. Boy, I wonder how we came up with that name. If we've got a point and we've got a slope, we've got the equation. We can just write it down just like this. And again, there's nothing to memorize here. If you just remember what slope means, that's You already know that. You know what slope is? Boom, you've got this. This is just another way of writing what slope is. You can see it's also exactly what we did here. There it is right there, the point slope form. There's the slope, and we've got the point 2, 1. There's the x coordinate, x goes with x, y goes with y. And you know, if you're trying to remember, oh, do I multiply the x part by the slope? Do I multiply the y part by the slope? Forget all that. Start from the definition of slope. You'll never get it wrong. Just remember what slope means. That's all you need to remember. And you already know point slope form. Now, of course, this isn't just useful in problems where you're given a point and a slope. What if we instead give you 2 points and no slope? Well, if we have 2 points, we have the slope. The slope is just the slope between these 2 points. Slope of the line between these two is the difference in the y-coordinates divided by the difference in the x-coordinates. 5 minus a negative 2, that's 7. 1 minus a negative 3, that's 1 plus 3, that's 4. So there's our slope. We've got 2 points. Which one should we use? You know what? I got some time. I'm just going to use both of them. I'm going to do both of them separately, and we'll see what happens. So point slope form, I'm going to use point slope form with this point right here. Take the difference in the y's. Y minus negative 2 is the slope times the difference in the x coordinates. X minus a negative 3, just like that. And you know, if I'm afraid I didn't quite remember that right, I can just see if I divided by this, I'd have the difference in the y's over the difference of the x's equals the slope. We're good. Now, we want to get rid of that fraction. We want to clean up this minus of a minus. I'm going to multiply both sides by 4. And this minus a negative 2 becomes y plus 2. And I'll have 7 times x plus 3 over here. I can expand both of these products, get 4y plus 8 equals 7x plus 21. Clean this up a little bit. I'll get my variables on the same side. I like to keep my x coefficient positive, so I'll subtract 4y from both sides. I'm going to subtract 21 from both sides, put the constant on the other side. I've got 7x minus 4y equals negative 13. Now let's check out what happens if I do the same thing, but with the other point. We start off with the difference in the y-coordinates. This is the slope times the difference in the x-coordinates. X minus 1, y minus 5, there's our slope. Multiply both sides by 4 again. And then we're going to expand these two products. And then once again, we're going to clean up. Get all my variables together, subtract 4y from both sides. And add 7 to both sides. Check it out. It doesn't matter which point we use. We get the same equation either way. Well, we should. It's the same line. There's another lesson hiding in here. We usually don't stop with just the point slope form when we write that down, because, you know, if I wrote this down as my answer and you wrote that down as your answer, are they the same? Who knows? You can't just glance at these and see that you've got the same equation. So usually what we do, we set it up with their point slope, and we work it through and we lay it out just like this. We get all the variables on one side, we get a constant on the other side, and you know, if you can, you get these coefficients to be integers, you make the coefficient of x be positive, and you write the equation just like this, which of course is just like this. We got a name for this too, because you know, we name everything, we call this the standard form. I don't really care about the names, I just care that we're done.